Hi, I'm John Storms, and I'm going to show you how to manually pull in an Audacity timing grid into your Light-O-Rama sequence. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to open up Light-O-Rama, and I am going to create the most basic of basic musical sequences. So I'm going to do the musical sequence, pick Batman Smells. I'm going to set up one controller. I am going to use no timings. Okay, and I'm going to save this as basic one, erase me, because I'm generating a lot of crappy files. And this has nothing in it. Okay, this is empty, empty, empty. So the reason I'm doing this is so I can demonstrate what it looks like inside one of these files, what you can expect to find. I go to my sequences directory. I find this file, okay, and I open it up in a notepad. And Light-O-Rama saves their stuff as XML files. This is great because basically an XML file is just a text representation of a database. And now we can pull things in, it represents everything that's in your sequence. Now this is a basic sequence, so there's not a lot here. Okay, and so you can see there's a section for channels, right? First of all, this first part here contains all the information about the sequence, especially when you initially start it up, where the audio file is and so on. This section describes all of your channels. This section describes your timing grids, your tracks, and then your animation. This would be the analyzer. Okay, and that's everything there is to know about this particular sequence. Now, timing grids are very simple. Okay, so this is the information about the timing grid, and then it stores the timing information in centiseconds. So if I come in here and I say, let's add a couple more lines, I can say 10, 20, and so 10 is in centiseconds, should be 1 second, all right, and then 30, and so on. Right. So I say save. Now, if I go back to Light-O-Rama and I open my sequence, you'll see that before I had no timing at all. Well, now I have three timings right here at 1 second intervals. Jingle bell. Very, very simple. Okay, so what I want to do though is Audacity has this great feature where you can do all these great things loading up a song. Now, I refer you to the wonderful people at Nutcracker, X-Lights and Nutcracker. Nutcracker 123/Nutcracker/releases. Okay. Don't know what it is. Here we go. Okay, and what you're going to want to do is you want to, of course, install Audacity, which is available in SourceForge. But then you also want to download the Queen Mary Vamp plugins for Audacity. Okay, that will give you these cool guys under Analyze. You can do bar and beeps, key detectors, note detectors, polysymphonic, all this wonderful stuff. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to open up the Batman Smells song. Okay, and here's the song. Now, what I can do is I can say Analyze, and I'm going to say find all the notes. Now, I haven't played too much, but there is a lot of different options that you can select, and I think this was the default one. I'm just going to use that as an example. I hit OK. What it does is it creates this label track where all the notes are. Okay. Now I'm going to rename this to Output Timing. Doesn't matter what you call it. And I come up to File, Export Labels. And I'm going to call it output timing, and I spelled it wrong, but who cares? Okay, so now I go to that directory. I find output timing, and see, this is the start of the note, the end of the note, and this is the value of the label. And I'm not sure exactly what value it popped in there, but it doesn't matter. And it gives, it's all this nice tab delimited. So when you hear tab delimited, you think, hey, this is a good job for Excel. As you can see, I was already playing with another one previous to this. Okay, so I'm gonna open up my new one. Output timing. Okay, so I have my tabbed eliminated data. Now, in this one, the start times and the stop times are the same. So what I want to do is I want to convert this from seconds to centiseconds. Well, this is very easy. I say take column A, multiply it by 10, and voila. I now have seconds. Copy that. All the way down. All the way down. Okay. Now, a little thing is that Light-O-Rama is not going to really use portions, so I'm going to say round. I'm going to use the round function. I'm going to say just round it up, round it down, round it to zero digits. And it's going to get me to the closest centisecond. Okay, so now this is in centiseconds. So there are 10 seconds to a centisecond. So now these I want to pull into the little text file or the XML file. Okay, it has this little format here. So I'm going to cheat a little bit. Now you could write a script to do this, probably will someday, but this is just to show the formatting of the file. Okay, and then there's this piece on the end. Same thing. Here, I'm going to keep the zero, and then I'm going to paste this in, and then I just need to clean it up a little bit. So I'm going to do this, Control C, Control H, paste, remove the extra tab, replace all, now do it in reverse for the other side. Control H, this, without the tab, replace all. XML doesn't care about the spacing, so you can leave it just like that. It might care about that one, probably won't. I hit save, I come back to Light-O-Rama, I look for this guy, and I did something wrong. Jingle bells, Batman's. Okay. Close that down. Say, Oh, those are all way too small. So, what did I do wrong? Well, it's probably in the math. It's always in the math. So I come back up to here and I say, okay. So centi means 100, not 10. Duh. Let's try this all again. You know, in seventh grade, they told me that the metric system would take over the world, and I didn't believe them, and I didn't learn it, and I just paid the price for it. Okay, this looks much better. Alright, we come back up. Repeat the process that I'm sure was so entertaining the first time. Paste that in. Clean up. Whoops. Well, I'll just redo this one. A little easier for the second time around. Save it. Back to Light-O-Rama. Open it up. Aha! Now this looks a little better.
Jingle bells, Batman smells, Robin laid an egg.
Okay, a little hard to see, so let's do this. Let's go ahead and put a note in each one of these. For some reason, I find myself doing this a lot from time to time. If anybody ever knows a better way of doing this versus just, you know, clicking over, hitting enter over and over and over and over and over and over and over again for 23 seconds a song. Bang, 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 bang. Jingle bells, Batman smells, Robin laid an egg. The Batmobile lost a wheel, and the Joker got away. Hey, jingle bells, you know, all the way. All right. So now, come over to my analyzer. Nope. I only got the one channel. Let's just make it something we can see. Let's see how it looks.
Jingle bells, Batman smells, Robin laid an egg. The Batmobile lost the wheel and Joker got away.
Hey!
Jingle bells, Batman smells, Robin laid an egg. The Batmobile lost the wheel and the Joker got away.
It did pretty good. So, that is how you manually pull in an Audacity timing grid into Light-O-Rama.